Good morning, church. I greet and welcome you all for this morning worship service. As we have come into the presence of the Lord, let us quieten our hearts and minds. Let us prepare ourselves to worship our living God. Let us spend a few minutes in silence. Thus says the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, let not the mighty man glory in his might, let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him who glories glory in this, that he understands and knows me, that I am the Lord who practice kindness, justice, and righteousness in the earth. For in these things I delight, says the Lord.
Spirit, faithful God, ever new the Christian side, gently lead us by the hand, pilgrims in a desert land, weary souls forever. While they hear that sweetest voice whispering softly, wanderer, come, follow me, I'll guide thee home.
Let us pray. Our most gracious and wonderful God, we thank you and we praise you for this morning. Thank you for this wonderful privilege that you have given to us to come to your throne of grace, worshiping you, adoring you, and to give you thanks. Thank you for this day and thank you for this moment, O Lord. We praise you and we thank you for all your wonderful things that you have done in each one of our lives. As we, your people, have gathered here in your presence, O Lord, as we sing praises to you, as we meditate upon your word, as we offer our offerings, offer our lives, we pray that Heavenly Father, fill us with thy Holy Spirit and help us to worship you in truth and in spirit, O Master. Help us to love you with all our hearts, with all our souls, with all our strengths and with all our minds, O Lord. Be present amidst of us, as you have promised, where two or three are gathered in my name, I will be there in their midst. Heavenly Father, strengthen your congregation to sing praises to your name and to worship you in spirit and in truth, O Master. You be the Alpha and the Omega of this service, O Lord, the beginning and the end. And you receive all glory, honor, and praise, and bless us through this service. We ask this prayer in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us all sing this hymn, praise him, praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer. As we sing this hymn, let us also praise God by singing this hymn. Praise him, Jesus, our blessed Redeemer.
Our blessed Redeemer, sing, O earth, his wonderful love proclaim. Hail him, highest archangels in glory, strength and honor give to his holy name. Like a shepherd, Jesus will guard his children. In his arms he carries them all day long. O ye saints that dwell in the mountains of Zion, praise him, ever in joyful song. Praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer, for our sins he suffered and bled and died. He our rock, our hope of eternal salvation. Hail him, hail him, Jesus the crucified. Loving Savior, meekly enduring sorrow, crowned with thorns that cruelly pierced his brow. Once for us rejected, despised and forsaken, Prince of glory, ever triumphant now. Praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer, heavenly Portus, loud with Hosanna ring. Jesus, Savior, reigneth forever and ever. Crown him, prophet and priest and king. Death is vanquished, tell it with joy, ye faithful. Where is now that victory boasting brave? Jesus lives no longer, thy portals are cheerless. Jesus lives, the mighty and strong to save.
As we continue to be in the Lord's presence, let us read responsively from the hymnal, hymnal 640, hymnal 640, second part. Let us read responsively. All we like sheep have gone astray.
We have turned everyone to his own way.
And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth.
Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter,
and like a sheep that before its shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth.
By oppression and judgment he has taken away.
And as for his generation, who considered that he was cut out of the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people.
And they made his grave with the wicked,
and with the rich man in his death.
Although he had done no violence,
and there was no deceit in his mouth,
yet it was the will of the Lord to bruise him.
He has put him to grief.
When he makes himself an offering for sin,
he shall see his offspring, he shall prolong his days.
The will of the Lord shall prosper in his hand.
He shall see the fruit of the travail of his soul and be satisfied.
By his knowledge shall the righteous one, my servant, make many to be accounted righteous.
And he shall bear their iniquities.
Therefore I will divide him a portion with the great,
and he shall divide the spoil with the strong.
Because he poured out his soul to the death,
and was numbered with the transgressors.
Yet he bore the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen.
Dear people of God, as we continue to be in the Lord's presence, it is right and appropriate for us to sing praises to his holy name, because he has done marvelous things in each one of our lives. He has protected us, he has sustained us. In response to his wonderful deeds, we, his disciples, we, his people, the only act we can do is an act of worship, praising God for all the things that he has done. As Psalmist in Psalms 95 says, "Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song." As the worship team comes forward and leads us in the time of singing and praise, let us join together and praise his holy name. Let us extol our God with music and song. Over to the worship team.
Good morning, church. What a wonderful day that the Lord has given us once again in our lives. And it is a joy to be back in the sanctuary of the Lord, worshiping with all of you through this online worship service. As we begin our worship session this morning, let us sing by singing a very familiar chorus, "Open the eyes of my heart, Lord, I want to see you." As we sing this, let us ask the Lord to open the eyes of our heart so that we can see him high and lifted up, shining in the light of his amazing glory. Let us sing this song, "Open the eyes of my heart, Lord." Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you, to see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, "Holy, holy, holy." Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, "Holy, holy, holy." To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, "Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy, holy. We cry, "Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you." The next song that we're going to sing is called "These Are the Days of Elijah." The words of the song says, "These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. These are the days of Moses, of famine and darkness and sword." Not very different from the times that we are living in. These are the days of sickness and uncertainty and of social distancing. So as we sing this song, let us remember that the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is not very far off. Behold, he comes very soon. Let us sing the song, "These Are the Days of Elijah." May I request you all to rise up to your feet wherever you are and clap our hands, and let us sing the song with full zest and valor.
These are the days of Elijah. declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee. And out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
These are the days of Ezekiel. The dry bones are becoming flesh. These are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. Hallelujah. Let us all praise him, church.
These are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. These are the days of the harvest, the fields are as white in your world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee. And out of Zion's hill salvation comes. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee. And out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
There's no God like Jehovah, 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 there's no God like Jehovah.
Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee. And out of Zion's hill salvation comes. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee. And out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, we pray to you this morning, O Master. We know that you're coming soon, O Master. We know that your second coming is not far away, O Master. Lord, we pray that your mercies be forever with us as we praise you and worship you in these days, O Master. These are days of great uncertainty, O Master. And we pray for your guidance to be with us every step of the way, O Master. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There's no God like you. Church, let us open our mouths and worship the Lord wherever we are. Let us just open our mouths and keep worshiping our Master, our Lord, our Savior. For his mercies are great. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Church, let us give him our hearts. Let us give him our everything. Let us surrender ourselves unto him. And let us live for him alone. The next song that we're going to sing is called, Lord, I Give You My Heart, I Give You My Soul.
This is my desire to honor you. within me. I give you praise, all that I adore is in you. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul, I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me.
Let us sing this once again, church. This is my desire to honor you.
This is my desire to honor you. Lord, with all my heart, I worship you. Within me, I give you praise. All that I adore is in you.
Lord, I give you my heart.
Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me.
Yes, Lord, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake, is only for you, O Master, and only because of the grace that you've shown us, O Master. Church, let us sing this. And I will live, and I will live for you, and only you.
And I will live, and I will live for you.
Everybody.
And I will live, and I will live for you. And I will live, and I will live for you.
One last time, church.
And I will live, and I will live for you.
Lord, I give you my heart.
Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I give for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me.
Lord, I gave you my heart, I gave you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, have your way in me. Yes, have your way in me. Our Heavenly Father, we surrender ourselves unto you, O Master. We lay ourselves before you, O Master. Have your way in our lives, O Master. Lord, we pray and we worship you this morning, O Master. We pray that you be with us. You lead us, you guide us, and you show us the way. And you have your way in us, O Master. Because we live only for you, O Master. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, as we move on with the worship service this morning, O Master, we pray that you speak to our pastor and let your word be revealed to us through him, O Master. We commit the rest of the worship service and all of us who is gathered around the world watching this, O Master. We commit each and every one of us into your mighty and protective hands. In Jesus' wonderful and matchless name we pray. Amen.
Dear people of God, as we continue to be in the Lord's presence, let us come before his throne of grace, thank him for all the wonderful things that he has done in our lives. Let us pour out our hearts and make prayer supplications in his presence, because we have hope in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As we read in Isaiah chapter 40 verses 29, he gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. As we have these words of assurance that if we are in the Lord, if our hope is in the Lord, he will renew our strength. As many of us are discouraged, as we are in anxiety and despair, it is the words of assurance that if we come to the presence of the Lord, if we have hope in our Lord, he will renew our strength. He will help us to soar like that of eagles. We run and we will not grow weary. Let us pray and surrender our lives. As I lead in this pastoral prayer, I request each one of you to pray in your hearts for your lives, for your families, and for your society. Let us pray. Gracious and merciful Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this morning. Thank you for this wonderful privilege that you have given to us to come to your throne of grace, calling you Abba Father and seeking your intervention in each one of our lives. Thank you for your words of assurance that ask and it shall be given, seek and you shall find, knock and the door shall be open unto you. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this wonderful privilege to ask you, to seek you, and to knock so that you will hear our prayers and you will open your doors to us. Lord, thank you for giving us this wonderful privilege to pray and to make supplications, to give you thanks for all creation. Hear us, O Lord, when we pray that it may please you to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. Help us, O Lord, that we may confess your name with courage and fidelity and to bear witness in this society, O Lord. We acknowledge that you are a creator, you are a maker. You know us by our name and you know each thought of ours. You know each tears that we shed, O Master. Hear us when we pray, O Lord. Lord, thank you for your grace and your mercies that has enabled us to see one more new day and that has enabled us to come to your throne of grace, O Master. As we, your people, come to your throne of grace, humbling ourselves with a contrite and broken heart, we pray that, Heavenly Father, you have searched us and you have known us. Lord, we pray that, Heavenly Father, you know all our prayer petitions before we ask, O Lord. We come to your throne of grace praying for our families. We thank you, O Master. Bless each one of us, O Master. We surrender each one of our lives into your mighty care. Protect us from all the evils, dangers, and illnesses, O Lord. Take away all the fear and anxiousness that we have in our society, O Lord. Take away this diseases, COVID-19, which is creating fear in every human heart, O Master. We pray that Heavenly Father take control of the situation. Lord, have compassion on each one of us, O Lord. Give us a space to live our lives with joy and happiness, O Master. At this moment, O Lord, we thank you for the gift of life that you have granted to each one of us. Thank you for good health. Thank you for your peace, joy, and happiness that you have bestowed upon each one of us. Thank you for your loving kindness, O Lord. It is better to live in your courts one day than 1,000 elsewhere. At this moment, O Lord, as we pray, incline your ears to our prayers. Let your goodness and mercies follow each day of our lives, O Master. Help us always to seek and to live in your house forever, O Lord. We acknowledge that we are sinners, yet, O Lord, through the precious blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, you have made us worthy of, Lord, calling you Abba, Father, worthy to come to your presence, O Lord. Lord, we commit ourselves and we confess all our sins, O Master, which we have done in word, deed, and action. Like David prayed, we too pray, have mercy on us, O Lord, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercies. Blot out all our transgressions, wash us thoroughly from our iniquities, cleanse us from our sin, grant us your favor. Remember not our sins, O Master. We confess all the sins that we have committed against you and our fellow beings, O Lord. Create in us a clean heart, renew a right spirit in us. Restore the joy of salvation, O Master. Let your light shine in our hearts. If there is anything evil in us, remove everything, O Master. Remove all the work of evil in our hearts, O Master. Deliver us from the bondage of sin. Lord, redeem us through your great strength and by your might. We confess all our sins, O Lord. Forgive us. Thank you for forgiving us in the name of Jesus, O Lord. We especially pray for our families. Thank you for being our Lord, our Master, our Savior, our Shepherd, and guiding us and sustaining us thus far. Thank you for being a provider, sustainer, and redeemer. Bless us through our families, O Master. Hold us close to your heart, O Lord. Let your love surround us. Let your love bind us together, O Master. Help each and every family member to grow in your love, in your care. Lord, help us to love each other and reflect your love in and through our words, deeds, and action. Draw us close to your side every day, O Lord. Help us to grow in you each new day, O Lord. Renew our strength like that of an eagle. When we pray for our dear and near ones, hear our prayer and grant all their heart's desire, O Lord. Surround us with your love. Keep us safe and secure during this pandemic, O Master. We especially pray for our spiritual family, Sarjapur Road Methodist Church. We surrender each and every family member into your mighty care, O Lord. In this time of difficulty, perplexities of changing order, as we are facing new challenges every day, we pray that Heavenly Father baptize your church afresh in the life-giving spirit of Jesus. Bestow upon your church a great responsiveness to the duty, a swifter compassion with suffering, and an utter loyalty to the will of God. Help your church to proclaim with courage and boldness the coming of kingdom of God. Put upon your church the task and responsibility of proclaiming the gospel to the people in this society, O Lord. Lord, we surrender each and every activity of this church into your mighty care. We especially thank you for the Sunday school, this divine space where children can come together and learn your word, O Lord. Bless every child, bless every teacher, bless every parent, O Master. Help each and every child to, Lord, learn your ways and follow the instructions that you have given to us through your word, O Master. As your word says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom and knowledge. Yes, O Lord, help each and every child to fear you and to gain the wisdom and knowledge from you, O Lord. Direct their paths, O Master, Lord. Lead them by the Spirit so that their ways might be pleasing unto thy sight. Mold them and shape them after your own heart. We especially pray for all the youth of this congregation. Bless each one of them. Lord, in their days of youth, help them to remember you as their creator. Surrender and submit their lives into your care, O Lord. Help them to trust in everything, O Master. Help them to trust you, O Master, and surrender their lives so that they can see miracles and wonders in their lives. We especially pray for
the youths who are seeking for a job. We pray that Heavenly Father open the doors for them, O Lord. Give them opportunities to earn the source of income, O Lord. Help them to earn a decent income for their families and live their life with dignity. We especially pray for the ones who are looking for alliances. You yourself bring them the right partners and unite them through holy matrimony and bless them through their families, O Master. Help them to set their lives as an example to many youth in the society, in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith and purity, O Lord. We especially pray for the women of this congregation. Bless each one of them. Thank you for their sacrifice. Thank you for their service. Thank you for their love rendered towards each one of us, O Master. Thank you for giving them as our mothers, our sisters and spouses, O Lord. Bless them, bless all the work of their hands, O Master. Give them extra portion of your grace and your strength as they serve us, as they take care of the families, as they lead the family in the paths of righteousness, O Master. We especially pray for men of this congregation. We surrender each one of them into your mighty care, O Lord, as they venture out into various professions, various activities. We pray that Heavenly Father bless all the work of their hands and establish them, prosper them. As your word says, commit all your ways and they will prosper. Yes, O Lord, we surrender each one of them. Bless all their endeavors and ventures, O Master. May they reap good fruits from all the efforts that they invest into, O Master. We thank you and we praise you. We especially pray for senior citizens of this congregation. Bless each one of them in their times of weakness and fragility. We pray that Heavenly Father, may your gracious and compassionate hand be upon them. Restore them to good health, O Master Lord. We pray that Heavenly Father, you be their rock, you be their fortress, you be their strength, you be their guide, and you be their hope, O Master. We especially pray for our church as we are seeking a new place and site for the church. We pray that Heavenly Father, show us a proper place, O Master, so that we can build your church, O Master. Lord, you be our cornerstone of this church, O Lord. What is impossible to man is possible to you, O Lord. Lord, we surrender every thought, every discussion, and every deliberation and decisions into your mighty care, O Lord. We ask you to go before us and make the crooked places straight in finding a site for the church, O Lord. We trust in you, O Father, with all our hearts. We lean not on our own understanding, but in all our ways we acknowledge you, and you shall direct our paths, O Master. Thank you, Lord, for your blessing on this path. We especially pray for our nation, India. Thank you for this land and its people. Thank you for the freedom that you have given to us to worship you, O Lord. We pray for our leaders. Help them to lead our nation in the paths of righteousness and peace. Inspire and guide them with your pure and peace loving wisdom, O Lord. Give your wisdom to those who bear authority in the affairs of humankind, to rule us with justice, peace, and prosperity. At this moment, we especially surrender our President Sri Ramnath Kovind, our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi, all the members of the parliaments, Chief Minister of all the states, especially Chief Minister of Karnataka State, all the members of the legislative assemblies and councils. Help them to govern us with justice and honor. Grant them your wisdom and strength to know to do thy will. Fill them with love and truth, O Master. Help them to frame policies for the poor, marginalized, oppressed and weaker sections of this society, O Lord. We especially pray for our church, Methodist Church in India. Especially we surrender Bengaluru Regional Conference and its Bishop NL Karkare and Bishop Amma Kamal Karkare into your mighty care. All the district superintendents, especially our district superintendent, Reverend Sebastian Ravi Kumar, all the pastors, deacons, evangelists, missionaries and lay preachers. Lord, help all of us to radiate Christ's love and service in and through our words, deeds and action in our ministry, that we may by our life and doctrine set forth your true and living example, O Master. Help us to rightly and duly administer all the sacraments that you have called us to do for your glory. We especially pray for the pastoral team at Koramangala Methodist Church. Thank you for your calling and anointing to each one of us to serve you in this church. We thank you for the life and witness of our senior pastor, Reverend Matthew George, our assistant pastors, Reverend Daniel Ezra Naveen, Reverend Martin Abhishek. Use each one of us as a mighty instrument in your vineyard. Fill us with thy Holy Spirit and use us for your glory, O Lord. Bless and favor the work of your servants, that multitudes may be brought from the kingdom of evil into the kingdom of thy dear Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We especially pray for our institutions,
We pray and surrender each and every leaders and principals and heads of the institutions into your mighty care, O Lord. Give them your grace and your mercies. Help them to radiate Christ and his characteristics in and through our words, deeds, and action, so that people may see our good deeds and glorify your name, O Lord. Deepen the influence and extend your power for the good of this society, O Lord. We especially pray for the people who are suffering from various illness and sicknesses. O Lord, at this moment, have mercy upon them, upon those who are passing through this sore trial. Inspire in us, in our fellow beings, the will to help our suffering brethren and sisters, O Lord. Help and protect and strengthen them according to their need. Comfort those in sorrow with the comfort of which is in Jesus Christ. We ask that they would bring healing, comfort, and peace. You would bring healing, comfort, and peace to their bodies. Restore them completely to good health. May your healing hand touch them and heal them at this moment. We especially remember Mr. Vijay Kumar, father of Mr. Raj, O Lord. As he has been tested COVID-19 positive, we pray that Heavenly Father, may your hand be upon him, O Lord. Help him to restore to good health, O Master. Stretch forth your healing hand upon him and heal him completely at this moment, O Lord. May your hand enable him to go through this process, O Master. Help him to trust in you, O Lord, so that you would bring healing. As your word says, unless you heal us, we are not healed. Unless you save us, we are not saved. Thank you for your promise in Jeremiah chapter 17, verses 14. Heal us, O Lord, that we will be healed. Save us, O Lord, we will be saved. For you are the one that we praise you. Lord, under your mighty wings, we surrender each one of us into your mighty care, O Lord. Protect our families from all the dangers and sicknesses, O Lord. Give us your grace and your mercies to always worship you, adore you, and to give you thanks, O Lord. We thank you and we praise you. We surrender each one of us into your mighty care and all the prayer petitions. And we ask this prayer in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray while we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our trespasses as we also forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. The scripture portion for this morning's meditation has been taken from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 21 to 25.
I'm reading the scripture portion for today. It is taken from the first letter of Peter, the chapter 2, verses from 21 to 25. I'm reading from ESV, English Standard Version. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example so that you might follow in his steps. He committed no sin, neither was deceit found in his mouth. When he was reviled, he did not revile in return. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but continued entrusting himself to him who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed, for you were straying like sheep, but have now returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. May God bless this words in our hearing, understanding, and meditation. Thank you.
May God add his blessings upon the reading, hearing, and the interpretation of his holy word. As we prepare ourselves to listen to God's message, shall we all sing this hymn number 223, hymn number 223, When We Walk With the Lord in the Light of His Word. Let us sing for the glory of God.
His word, what a glory he sheds on our way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a burden we bear, not a sorrow we share, but a toil he doth richly repay. Not a grief for a loss, not a frown or a cross, but is blessed if we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. But we never can prove the delights of his love until all on the altar we lay. For the favor he shows and the joy he bestows are for them who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. When in fellowship sweet we will sit at his feet, or we'll walk by his side in the way. What he says we will do, where he sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Let's pray. Gracious our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this morning. Thank you for this beautiful opportunity that you have given to us to come to your throne of grace, seeking your voice, seeking your guidance in our lives, O Master. As we have gathered here to listen to your message, we pray that Heavenly Father, open our hearts, open our minds, help us to see the truth that is revealed to us through the word, O Lord. We pray that Heavenly Father, give us the power of Holy Spirit to understand the deeper meaning of your word, and in the light of your word, help us to reflect our lives, get encouragement, inspiration, and correction, so that we might live our lives which is pleasing unto thy sight. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock, our redeemer. Amen. Dear people of God, the topic for this morning's meditation is becoming like Christ. Becoming like Christ. The world today in which we are living is filled with evil, and the world teaches us to live our lives in evil ways. Just like the computer program, which has only two options to say yes or no, whether we belong or not belong to this group. As we see, the world teaches us which is opposite to Bible. But Jesus in his teachings always taught us that we have to be in this world but not of this world. We have to react being in this world in particular way as Christians who are called according to his will, plan and purpose in our lives. That's where in second chapter of 1 Peter, verses 18 to 25, Peter emphasizes that the purpose of our calling is to follow the footsteps of Jesus, to follow Jesus and his footsteps, to imitate Christ. To imitate Christ, we have to be very close to Jesus so that we can imitate him appropriately and rightly. as 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 18 to 25 when we read, in this paragraph Peter addresses the Christian slaves in the congregation and he stresses the importance of being submissive in their workplace. Some of the newly converted Christians, with their spiritual freedom, they also thought they were free politically as well as personally. They created problem for themselves as well as in the church. That's where Peter addresses this group of new converts, slaves, and he says to be submissive to their authorities. Paul also dealt with this problem in 1 Corinthians chapter 7 verses 20 to 24, and he touched this topic in his letter to his friend Philemon. The gospel eventually overthrew the Roman Empire and the terrible institution of slavery. Even though the early church did not preach against this institution of slavery, but it gave an emphasis and importance to the people who were under someone working. Today we might not have this institution of slavery, but we have employer and employees. Peter wrote that we, as working with someone, some authorities, that we have to be submissive to those who are over us. Whether they are kind or unkind to us, we are called to imitate Christ in our submissiveness. Imitate Christ in our unjust situation. Imitate Christ in our workplace, so that in our sufferings, so that Christ and God might be glorified in and through our work, in and through our deeds, in and through our honesty. He encourages the slaves to do good, work really hard and honestly, and earn their income. Sometimes many Christian employees may be wronged by our authorities, by our unbelieving co-workers or supervisors or managers. But Peter is saying, for Christ's sake, he or she should take it, even though it is not in wrong. Even if we have not committed mistake, even if we are not worthy of any suffering, Peter is encouraging that we have to take it for Christ's sake. For he says that, for this is the grace to bear reproach when you are innocent. As Matthew chapter 5 verses 10 to 12 talks about, a Christian should go through this phase of suffering, pain, and injustice for Christ's sake. God gives us the grace to submit and take it, and this is the way which glorifies God. Of course, the human tendency for us is that to retaliate, to fight back and demand our rights. This is a natural way of responding to the threat or injustice that happens to each one of us, that we defend ourselves. We use many defensive mechanisms against our authorities. But what Peter is suggesting here in his letter is that to be submissive because they are in Christ, and Christ gives them grace to endure all their sufferings. What we can understand from this is that we can fight back, but we are called to imitate Christ by following the example of Jesus Christ. We are called to be spirit-filled Christians, to submit and to let God fight our battles. In Bible, the duty is always connected with the doctrine. When Paul wrote to the slaves, he related his admonition to the doctrine of grace of God. Peter connected his counsels to the examples of Jesus Christ, God's suffering servant. And Peter learned through his own experience that God's people serve through suffering. At first, Peter opposed Christ's suffering on the cross. When we read Matthew chapter 16 verses 21, when the Roman soldiers came to arrest Jesus, Peter was the one who took his knife and cut the ear of one of the soldiers. He learned that Jesus, even at this point, he did not call the army of angels, or he did not take anyone's help. Rather, he allowed God to work in this situation. He allowed God to take control of the situation. He submitted himself to the will of God. He also learned that this kind of suffering will always lead to God's glory. As Jesus, through his word, deeds, and action, always glorified God, even in his suffering, as he glorified God, Peter was encouraged by this act of Jesus that in and through our suffering, we glorify God. That's where he encourages the suffering slaves in this congregation by presenting three pictures of Jesus Christ. From verses 21 to 23, he gives a picture of Jesus as an example. Jesus is an example for these suffering slaves. He says that all that Jesus did on the earth, recorded in four Gospels, it is a perfect example for us to follow, is our example in the way he responded to the suffering. Dear people of God, we should understand the world expects us to react, whereas Jesus expects us to respond. There is a difference between reaction and responding. Jesus is asking us to respond in our suffering by setting an example to each one of us. In spite of the fact that he was sinless, in both word and deed, he suffered in the hands of the authorities. Peter used his sword in the garden to fight back, but Jesus told him to submit to the will of God. Jesus proved that a person can be in the will of God, be greatly loved by God, and still suffer unjustly. In today's context, there is a shallow brand of popular preachings and popular theology that claims that Christians will not suffer if they are in the will of God. Those who promote such ideas have not meditated properly on the cross of Christ. They say that if you are in the will of God, you will not suffer. If you are out of will of God, we will suffer. And many of us do know, when there is persecution, when there is suffering, when there is pain and illnesses in our families, in our lives, many of us tend to drift away from Jesus, drift away from the faith and trust in Jesus, and many of us go to our old nature, go into our old pattern of life. What we see here is Jesus set an example for each believer through his humility and submission. Humility and submission is not an evidence of weakness, but of power. Jesus could have summoned the armies of heaven to rescue him. His words to Pilate in John chapter 18, verses 33 to 38 are proof that he was in complete control or command of the situation. It was Pilate who was on trial, not Jesus. Jesus committed himself to the Father, and the Father always judges rightly. Dear people of God, we are called to follow Jesus very closely, his footsteps very closely, and to imitate the example of Christ. Jesus told Peter and all his disciples at his last supper that no servant is greater than his master. If they have persecuted me, they will persecute you also. Jesus, in and through this preaching, is communicating to each one of us that if they have persecuted Jesus Christ, they will definitely persecute his believers, and is preparing each one of us to endure this suffering, because Christ has suffered and he has set an example for you and me to live. Even in our suffering, we have to glorify God rather than taking revenge on the people in this world. He suffered great injustice in order to obtain our salvation. He endured the unbelief of his own people. As John chapter 1 verses 11 talks about, even his own people did not accept him. He endured the trial by religious leaders already committed to his death. Mark chapter 14 verses 1 talks about the religious leaders were always waiting for an opportunity to trap Jesus, to kill Jesus. Whenever they got an opportunity, they were waiting as he performed miracles, as he was preaching and teaching, to find fault in his words and in his deeds. He endured the lies of false witness. Matthew chapter 26 verses 59 to 60, when we read, there were many false witnesses against Jesus. He endured beating, mockery from his people and from Roman soldiers. He was mercilessly flogged. He was tendered insults by bystanders, and he was separated from God, and he said, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" That's where he gives an example. Peter is writing to the believers or the slaves during his time, and he says, we are called to this, you were called because Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should also follow in his steps. Some of the translations, it says, you imitate Christ. Dear people of God, we are called to imitate Christ in and through our lives, to follow the example of Jesus, which is of complete peace and trusting in God and his mission in his life. Peter has learned, and in return he is teaching his fellow believers that to be submissive, to trust, because we are called to trust and follow the example of Jesus. Christ has given believers an example of how they are to face the injustice and persecution. Jesus said, if anyone wants to become my follower, let them deny themselves and take up the cross and follow me. If anyone wants to become my follower, let him deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. The Greek word for example is used as hypogrammaton, which was a model of handwriting set up by masters for their students to copy. The word is used here as a figure of speech for a model of conduct of imitation. Peter set up Christ as a model for believers to follow. And therefore, we, being the disciples and believers of Christ, in this time of difficulty, despair, and this time of great trial and tribulation, we are called to set an example in the society as imitators of Christ, to follow the example of Christ in his suffering, and his enduring of pain, mockery, guilt, and all that he went through for you and me. As we suffer, as we go through this time of trial and tribulation, we become close to God. We draw closer to God each and every day. As Miguel D. Molin says, you are never at any time nearer to God than when under tribulation, which he permits for the purification and beautifying of our soul. You are never at any time nearer to God than when under tribulation, which he permits for the purification and beautifying of our souls. Dear people of God, as we go through these tribulations and trials and persecutions, even when we are going through this injustice that is meted to us in this world, we are called to have patience, to endure, and to follow the example of Jesus Christ. Secondly, Paul encourages these slaves during his time. He says that Jesus is our substitute in his death. Verses 24 talks about, he himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. He died as sinner's substitute. Jesus Christ died for you and me. He died as a sinner's substitute. This entire section reflects the great servant, suffering servant chapter of Isaiah chapter 53. Jesus did not die as a martyr. He died as a sinner's substitute, as a savior, as a sinless substitute. The Jewish people did not crucify criminals. They stoned them to death. But if the victim was especially evil, his dead body was hung on the tree until evening as a mark of shame. Deuteronomy chapter 21 verses 23, when we read, this was the punishment given to a victim who is of very evil in his nature. Jesus died on the cross, on a tree, and bore the curse of the law. Christ was wounded that we might live. We died with him. We died to sin, as we see in Romans chapter 6, so that we might live our lives in righteousness. Peter mentions, because Christ bore our sins, because Christ died for us, because Christ was wounded for us, so that we might live in righteousness. If we are called to live our lives unto righteousness, Peter is encouraging this group of people to endure this pain and suffering, to go through this trial and tribulation, to prepare themselves to suffer for Christ. That's what Peter mentions in 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 24. The healing which he mentions is not the physical healing, but rather the spiritual healing of the soul. It is Jesus, the spotless Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, who saves us, not any other thing in this world. Christ was completely sinless in his life and in his words. When he was abused, oppressed, instead of taking revenge or retaliating, Jesus entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. As we see that Jesus committed his life even on the cross, when one of the thieves abused or mocked Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, you save yourself and save us too." Jesus, in response, he said, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." As Jesus entrusted himself and his sufferings to God, we who are called as his disciples, followers, can entrust ourselves and our sufferings into God's hand, knowing that God will ultimately do all right for us. All the wrongs that has been done to us will be used to make right for us. It is a comforting word to all the believers by God that in suffering he is right beside us. He helps us to respond appropriately even in our sufferings. You and I, as disciples of Christ, as believers, the only thing we have to do is to submit ourselves to the will of God, to surrender our lives to the will of God. As we read, that submission is voluntarily cooperating with someone, first out of love and respect for God, and second out of love and respect for that person. Submitting to a non-believer is difficult, but it is a vital part of leading them to Jesus Christ. We are not called to submit ourselves to non-believers to be to the point that we compromise our relationship with God, but we must look for every opportunity to humble ourselves and to bring them to the power of God and God's Spirit. Submission is functional. It distinguishes our roles and work we are called to do. It is relational, as it enables us to love and acknowledge one another's value as person. It is reciprocal, it is mutual, it is humble cooperation with one another, and it is universal, as it acknowledges the Lordship of Jesus Christ in all our endeavors in our life's journey in this society. Thirdly and finally, Peter encourages this group of people or slaves that Jesus is our shepherd in heaven. Verses 25 talks about, for you were like sheep going astray, but now you have returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. For you were the sheep going astray, but now you have returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls. In Old Testament, as we see, the sheep died for the shepherd. The sheep was used for the profit, for the gain of the shepherd. But in Jesus' context, as Jesus came into this world in a human form, as he performed miracles, as he had compassion towards the people who were suffering from various illnesses, sicknesses, Jesus communicated to the people that the real shepherd, the true and genuine shepherd, will die for his sheep. He showed them through his act of dying on the Calvary. In this context, the shepherd died for the sheep. John chapter 10 talks about Jesus as the good shepherd. He lays down his life for his sheep. Every lost sinner is like a sheep gone astray, ignorant, lost, wandering, and in danger, away from the place of safety and unable to help himself or herself. But Jesus, as we read in Luke chapter 15, verses 1 to 7, the shepherd, a caring, compassionate shepherd, goes in search of the lost sheep, and he dies for the sheep. Now that as we are returned to the fold of God safely in his care, as he watches over us, we have to stay with him and not to get lost in the sin. The word as a shepherd is used in Ezekiel chapter 34 Luke chapter 15 and John chapter 10, even in Psalms 23, that the Lord is our shepherd and we shall not be in want. Here, Peter is encouraging this group of people to trust in their shepherd. Once we were astray, once we were like sheep going astray, but now because we have returned to our shepherd, to our shepherd's fold, the overseer of our souls, we are to imitate Jesus Christ. We are to follow his example. We have to follow his example in suffering and also in shepherding. Dear people of God, this is the wonderful truth that Peter wanted to share to these slaves who went against their authorities, who went against their masters. He said, don't create problems for yourselves as well as for the church. Rather, you live your lives, godly lives, according to your calling. He encouraged them to live their lives according to their calling and submit in times of suffering. Just by following the example of Christ, by following the example of Christ, we become more like him. We submit and obey, not only for the sake of lost souls and for the Lord's sake, but also for our own sake, for our own good, that we may grow spiritually and become more like Christ. Sir Henry William Baker says, the King of love, my shepherd is, whose goodness never faileth. I lack nothing if I am in his will, and he is mine forever. The King of love, my shepherd is, whose goodness never faileth. I lack nothing if I am in his will, and he is mine forever. Dear people of God, it is an encouragement to each one of us as we are going through this difficult times or despair times and times of uncertainties. It is an encouragement for us to bear, to endure, and to persevere in this time of difficulty. Just by following the example of Jesus Christ, because he set an example that even in his suffering, Jesus was submitting himself to the will of God. Even as a suffering servant, he died for others' sake, even though he was unjustly trialed, unjustly judged, he bore that to bring glory to God. And there is hope for each one of us that he is a watchful shepherd to each one of us. May God bless each one of us as we go through this time of trials and tribulations. May his grace and may his hand be upon each one of us. May we be assured, may we find hope in our great shepherd, that is Jesus Christ, who cares for us. Let us pray and surrender our lives into God's hand. Gracious, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this morning. Thank you for speaking to us through the letter of Peter, chapter 2, verses 21 to 25, O Master. Thank you for speaking to us. Thank you for encouraging us to be submissive to our authorities and to reflect your example even in our sufferings, even in our injustice situation. Lord, because you are there as a shepherd to guide us and lead us, you are there to inspire us to bring glory to God even through our sufferings, pain and struggles, O Master. Lord, at this moment, when we consider the severe injustice that you faced, it is shocking for us that you did not sin in any way. Help us also not to sin in any way when we go through severe injustices in our lives. Lord, thank you for setting a beautiful example for us, which gives us strength to face our struggles with hope, O Master. Thank you for your unique suffering on the cross on our behalf. Because you face the cross alone, we will always have a shepherd to walk beside us in our trials. Help us by your grace to struggle well in our own difficulties and offer words of true comfort to those people who are in need. Thank you, O Master. Fill us with thy Holy Spirit to face the challenges of this world with confidence and with hope that we have in our great shepherd. We thank you and we praise you. We surrender and submit our lives into your care.
And we ask this prayer in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us invoke God's blessings upon those people who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries. May God be gracious and compassionate to them. May God add His blessings upon their lives as they step into this new year. Let us pray and surrender their lives into God's care. Let us pray. Gracious our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this morning. Thank you for the lives of your dear people who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries. Thank you for bringing them into our fellowship. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to rejoice along with them for your goodness, your mercies, and your greatness in their lives, O Lord. At this moment, we especially thank you for the lives of your dear people who are celebrating their birthdays. Lord, thank you for wonderfully creating them in their mother's womb and bringing them into this world and guiding them throughout their life's journey, O Master. Thank you for your faithfulness, goodness, and mercies in their past years. You had been a gracious and compassionate God, giving them good health, peace, joy, and happiness, O Lord. As they step into this new year, we thank you for their lives. And Lord, may this new year bring them good blessings, O Lord. May this new year give them good memories, O Master. May you be gracious and compassionate and grant all the desires of their heart, O Master. Help them to always rejoice in you, O Master, for all the wonderful things that you do in their lives, O Lord. Help them to surrender their lives. Help them to draw closer to you each and every day, O Lord, so that they might see your work, your hand in their lives. We especially pray for the ones who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. We surrender each couple into your mighty care, O Lord. Bless them. Thank you for uniting them through holy matrimony and blessing them all through these years, O Master, as they step into this new year. We pray that Heavenly Father, that may this new year bring them good blessings, O Lord. Help them to rejoice in your providence. Help them to rejoice in your protection, O Lord. We pray that Heavenly Father, give them your love so that they can love each other, so that they can grow in your love, O Lord. Help them to care for each other. Help them to always remain faithful in their marital covenant and glorify your name, O Master. We thank you and we praise you. We ask this in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Dear church, there are a few announcements for the church. We continue to worship God through this online platform for a few more months. Kindly pray in your hearts. Kindly participate prayerfully in the service. Our services begin at 9:30 a.m. Kindly log into our website and follow the service. Sunday school is happening online. Parents are requested to make provisions so that your children can be part of this Sunday school. Kindly note the timings, which is displayed on the screen, and also encourage children to be part of this Sunday school. We as SRMC have got a new bank account. The QR code will be displayed on the screen. Kindly make note of this. Contributions and offerings can be made towards this new bank account. God bless you all. In response to the message that we have heard, shall we all sing this hymn, hymn number 261, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Hymn number 261, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. While we sing this hymn, let us also offer our offerings. Offerings can be offered in three ways. We have got a new bank account. The QR code is displayed on the screen. Kindly mention your names in the description box and you can offer. For other options, kindly visit our website, srmcblr.org. And those of us who are not tech savvy, kindly store your offerings in your homes. Whenever the church doors open, bring it to the altar of the Lord.
Let us all sing the same. What a friend we have in Jesus.
In Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? Should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrow share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with the load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there. Amen.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him, thou heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Let us pray. Our most gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for this privilege that you have given to us to appear before your throne of grace with the little things that we have in our hands. Lord, as we bring these little offerings to your altar, bless it, consecrate it, and use it for the betterment of your kingdom. Lord, we acknowledge that you are a provider. Out of your blessings, we bring this little portion. Lord, wherever it is used, Lord, may it bring hundredfold fruits to your kingdom, O Master. As your word has promised, open the floodgates of heaven and shower your manifold blessings upon each one of us, O Master. Lord, we offer ourselves as a living sacrifice holy, acceptable, precious in thy sight, O Lord. All the resources that we have, all the talents and skills that we have, help us to use it for your glory and for the benefit of humanity around us, O Lord. Lord, as we move out from this place, we pray that Heavenly Father, give us your grace and your mercies to live our lives in this society. Lord, we pray that Heavenly Father, fill us with thy Holy Spirit to face all the challenges of this world, O Master. As your word has spoken to us, that to endure all the sufferings and pain, all the fear in this world, O Master, because you have set an example, even in your suffering, you were gracious and compassionate. You surrendered and submitted your life to the will of God. Help us also to submit our lives to the will of God and to endure all the sufferings, because you are there as a shepherd, a hope for each one of us, that you will provide and you will care for each one of us, O Lord. We thank you and we praise you for your words of assurance. O Lord, you be our provider, our sustainer, O Master, in this time of pandemic. We pray that Heavenly Father, put your edge around us through the fire of Holy Spirit and protect our families from all the dangers, evil activities, and these diseases, O Master. We surrender each one of us and our entire church and all the members into your mighty care. May your peace, may your joy, may your happiness be our portion. We ask this prayer in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us now in faith receive the benediction. Now may the God the Father be apparent to us, loving us and caring for us. May Jesus Christ be our constant companion, reminding us of God's love, redeeming us from our sins. And may the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us, keeping us safe while we are apart from one another. The blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us from now and forever. Amen.